That is up to you right now.
And he was so fast too. You know, Moses was trying to make it to the life raft, and Mo just shoved him out of the way, right? Like, you're gonna be in there first.
Yeah, maybe a bad sign for Echo Fox. What happens when things start to go bad there? All right, well, we do have NIP starting on the terrorist side, and we've got Optic on the CT side, and we are on Train, which is a fun map. And one that, I mean, initially no one wanted to play, but now it's been around for a little bit in this new iteration, new form, and people seem to be playing it quite a bit. Exist with a flashy jumping burst fire shot. If that had worked, I would have just stopped talking.
Basically, yeah, because what else can you do but, you know, stare in awe of the mechanics of CSGO, where you can just go and burst, jump, block, and, you know, it all works out. Good actual adjustment here from Optic, though. They do fall back. As soon as NIP put that initial pressure on there, now they're looking to take the fight at range with the USPs. They just need to get some headshots out of it, and, well, Mixwell will finally deliver. He picks up one on Getright. He could go for another, but Freiberg is going to shut him down.
Good shot from Rush, and they still have a grenade on Naf and a defuse kit. This could work out right now. Pi's going to be pushing up, and he's got no cover here. Has to try and get back behind the train. Runs right into Rush. Great timing right now for Optic, and Rush coming up with a triple kill. Fantastic play here from the North American side. And Optic going to be winning the pistol round. That's a bit of a change in itself.
An excellent recovery. After the initial fight, they spotted out so many members from NIP. They fall back to try and make use of their USPs to render the Glocks a little bit more, well, less effective. Basically, because the Glocks, you need two shots, basically. You can't just one-shot headshot the way you can with the USP.
Now look at this. Second round in, and we have Getright with the UMP.
Yeehaw.
They lose the pistol, and they manage to make this buy home. If this works, it's something that we've almost never seen outside of matchmaking, where you hate on your teammates for doing this, but I'd be surprised if this could work out.
NIP have a patented kind of strat that they like to run over here towards alley, though, but it's not going to matter. Freiberg's going to find the kill on Nafly, and, well, Optic, they went aggressive because they're probably expecting NIP to be on a hard eco, considering they got the bomb plant in the last round. They're thinking, well, NIP are going to save, so maybe we just go in and farm up some kills, make some money, and we worry about the third round. Instead, it's all action right now here on the A side. NIP is charging out, but Stanislaw and Rush doing a good job of holding the site for now.
Yeah, and Daps, this time, the timing is actually perfect. Unlike on Cobblestone, where he was perpetually 10 seconds late, this time he helps out. Otherwise, Stanislaw would have probably gone down to that flank coming through. So great play right now, Optic. And the risk that NIP took in buying in this round, it is not paying off at the moment. Doesn't mean it can't change. Freiburg and Exist are still left, and can't just underestimate them either.
No. Can't really give them much space to work with, but three players, well, four players now on the A side here for Optic, and they're watching all the angles of approach onto this A side as well. It's not looking real good here for the Ninjas. They kind of have to split up, it looks like, and hope that somebody's going to get impatient on the Optic side, but Optic have no reason to go hunting. All they need to do now is just sit and wait, because they do have, well, they basically have NIP boxed in on this side of the map. So it just comes down to holding the angles. Even though Rush is going to push around that corner, it looks like 6 HP left on Rush. Instantly going to get picked off. No idea what's going on there. And there's Stanislaw getting dropped on the site. It's down to Daps and Mixwell, and Mixwell's only on 1 HP.
Yeah, Daps might have to do a lot of work right now. The one big thing is that NIP can't make it to the B bomb site, so they are kind of committed to staying here. And if they try and plant, they don't know about Daps being behind Electric. Exist finding the perfect position. They cannot stop this plant. It's going to go through, and Exist will go down. It's all on Freiburg. He's got the M4. One headshot on Daps here, and Mixwell is on one health. This might still work out. Bit of a flashbang going over there. No kit currently picked up on anyone on Optic, so they can't waste all the time in the world right now. Daps going to go in for the shot, and he's going to be successful as well. Good round there, and they should be able to get the defuse home. They will have enough time. That's so scary. That could have been around for NIP.
Absolutely, yeah. Freiberg, you can see the frustration from him. He knows that they were close, that he could have got the job done. If he wins that fight straight up, it turns it into a 1v1 situation. He has no idea that Mixwell is so low, but a 1v1, definitely you can win that as the T side when the bomb is already planted. So a very close call there for Optic, and that nearly worked for NIP, that force buy. Now we are actually, we should. I mean, I'm not going to, well, no, never mind. Before I can even finish the sentence. I was hesitating for a second there because they actually had a few guys who could afford to get rifles on NIP side. And yeah, NIP, they realize how close they came in the last round. They just want to keep that pressure up. They do not want to let Optic get comfortable.
Right, and if you want to know the logic to why NIP are buying, if you bring up the scoreboard here, it's the Optic's money that's the real big thing here. Only two of them on any kind of money, and the rest really don't have that much. So that's why they want to keep forcing the issue here. Maybe it'll work. They certainly have a better buy than last time.
I mean, now they have a couple of rifles to work with. They have that MP7 on Freiburg as well. So they have a good chance at actually overwhelming the defense fairly quickly here. And Optic, they do have two players on that B site, but again, those two players holding pretty far back. And Pyth has been spotted. Mixwell jumping on the ramp. He's going to be able to spot out Pyth on upper. And now two players. It's just a straight split onto the B site. Now it comes down to the retake scenario here for Optic. If Daps can pick something up, that'd be great. But Forrest is going to catch him out in the open.
And I think Daps mistakenly jumped there. I think he misclicked the button because he jumped in the middle of that train. And that's instant death if you're that exposed. Very low on health right now is Freiburg, but still being a bit of a nuisance here, getting a little bit of damage in there, but Get Right picking up two kills with the deal before he goes down to Naf. It's still a 2-on-3. They do have a smoke there, and they even a Molotov there on Naffly, so really good job on him right now, but they need Rush to come up with a defuse, and NIP pushing out, maybe a little bit too aggressively then, but still going to pick up the kill. And now 1-on-2, and Pyth shooting Naffly in the back. He's been playing a great round so far. He's got the triple, going close to the deagle, not going to win the round. But I mean, again, a lot of damage being dished out here. NIP barely winning the round, but that's enough. Only two of the members right now on Optic can even afford to buy.
Exactly. And that was some nice work there from Get Right. The mid-air headshot on Stanislaw as he's jumping between the trains with the deagle, that's not a bad play. But that is NIP getting on the board now. One round to them, two for Optic. And because of the state of the economy here for Optic, they aren't going to go for the force buy. If they save now, it means that Mixwell can get the AWP in the next round. But Stanislaw is practically broke, and Daps and Rush don't have much in the bank either. So we'll see what Optic elect to do in the next round. NIP, though, this is what they love to do. They like to just go straight aggressive out. A main Freiburg going to take point with that MAC-10, pick up the first kill. But Naffly is there to take out Pit.
And Freiburg seeing it coming that this was going to be an eco round, so just buying that MAC-10. Good return fire right now. Mixwell, look at that, doing great damage with a double kill. And Exist going to be alone in a 1-on-3. And NIP potentially throwing away a really big opportunity to get back in this game right here. Optic, they're going to be celebrating if they could win this round. The bomb is out there, so they could even maybe find a couple of rifles while Exist is shuffling around back here at the T spawn, more or less.
Yeah, they don't know, so long as that, well, the smoke is cleared up now, but they have no idea where Exist is coming from, and that's why they're a little bit scared here of actually moving out, you know, exposing themselves. Instead, it's Exist. He's worked his way around to A main now, trying to change up that angle, but there is a man in Sniper who will be able to spot this play coming in from Exist. And the man on site, that's Stanislaw, he's going to have to play it very carefully here, but Daps is the one who's keeping an eye out on upper, and we'll see if Exist actually walks into his line of sight. Exist is just hoping to get this flank in. And yeah, this is really sick here from Stanislaw. He falls back to connector. Now he's really just making sure there's only one angle, really, that Exist can be coming from. Unless Exist elected to go for the backstab, they are checking for it, but there's confirmation. Exist with a wallbang shot onto Daps, but Stanislaw still alive in connector, so we have to see, can Exist actually pull this off? 20 seconds left.
Oh, gonna be walking around, and there's the shot. The timing couldn't be better. I mean, it's a hard situation to play there, because you could also try and wait for Exist to get the bomb down and use that beep sound just to get the initial fight in. Didn't work out this time for NIP, but Optic, they're going to be so happy right now. That was a save round for them. They have so much money to work with now, and NIP, they don't have a lot, and they're still going to be buying. This is what is going on. If this was Envy, I wouldn't be surprised if it was the old version of Envy, but because it's NIP, you don't normally see them buying this aggressively.
I think that the reasoning behind this for NIP is just like, hey, we have to double eco. So you know what? Just go for the buy. Hope we get lucky here. Pull something off. Again, this is one of NIP's favorite plays, to put three players over towards Alley, kind of stack up over here, and hope to just kind of crush onto the defense with the help of Forrest, who's working from A main. But there's the flash. Rush is exposed. Forrest missing shots. And then Forrest, he eventually will find the headshot. So now the defense has been weakened, and there's a chance. But Naffly through the smoke is going to spray down Exist.
Good little kill there to stabilize the situation a bit. Looked like it was going to get maybe out of control. Look at how close Pyth is, just sneaking into Stannis there and nearly getting a kill on him. AK not going to get the fight, actually. Freiburg, long range with the Tech-9, going to take it out instead. The bomb is planted, and this shouldn't be going the way that it is right now. Optic, they need to get back and win this round, and they're just being way too passive. They're walking in one at a time. Where's the collective team push coming from? And Pyth, close range, picks up one, trying for the double kill right now. Mixwell, oh! He turns around. Look how on point he is. Just precision kills coming through, but it is too late. And that whole retake from Optic, I even hesitate to call it a retake. It was more like one member at a time stumbling into the bomb site. Not quite good enough.
Where's the discipline? I think that's the main question here. If you have that man, you have the superior firepower, you have the man. I mean, you guys should be able to just work together. Take your time, pace yourself. You know, think Fnatic, think Luminosity. Teams that just, you know, going into retakes, they'll just sit for 10 seconds, 15 seconds, wait to see if their opponents are going to try and get aggressive before making sure that, you know, okay, everybody's in position. Okay, right, go. Now start moving in together as a unit. It's just, yeah, everybody trying to be a hero there for Optic, and it really didn't work out. Although Bixwell did do a good job of bringing it back, making it close. Still, Optic have to sit on pistols this round, although Stanislaw has picked up a Swag 7. He's going to have that shotgun. We'll see where he decides to actually take that fight. Seems like, yeah, he's just holding close B halls.
This is devastating right now for Optic. I mean, I think mentally this is hard to come back from. Stan is in a good position. Flashbang going to go just past his head, so he didn't get flashed and he did a lot of damage to Pyth there, but still going to be an opening frag favoring NIP. And that leaves the rest of the defense here looking not that impressive.
That's such thorough play from NIP, though. They realize that they should be going up against an eco, but they still aren't skimping. They still decide, okay, right, you know, we're going to have two guys there, so they should be able to trade frag, but what we'll do is we'll actually get a third man over there with the flash grenade and really go through the motions, give them as good a shot as possible of just getting in there scot-free. So the pressure went out on the B site, but NIP are going to wrap back onto A, and get right jumping through has spotted the one man out in the open.
Yeah, and with Knapp going down and Freiburg picking up that kill on Rush, you've got to expect that there's not much left for Optic in a round like this one. Just try and see if they can do a bit more. Hiding inside the smoke is Mixwell. Oh, assists! He's going to be saved by Forrest, so some good teamwork coming out this time around. That will tie up the scoreline at 3-3. And look at the money on Optic, still not very good. In fact, I think they're going to be saving again.
That is a perfect anti-eco coming out. That's exactly what you need to be seeing from NIP, not what we saw. And I think they learned their lesson, basically, because obviously the last time they lost versus that eco, they kind of ran around, they were cutting corners, you know, feeling really confident. It was good that they got that reality check pretty early on, because that last round that you just saw, that anti-eco, was exactly how you're supposed to play it. Make good use of your nades, move together in pairs, you know, just work as a team and pace yourselves. It's very nice to watch. But the score is now tied up 3-3, and Optic, still not enough money to go for the full buy. So another anti-eco round here for NIP, and they should be able to figure that out pretty soon here.
I think mentally speaking, Optic, the comeback should have happened when they won their own eco round, right? When they picked up that round, that's when things changed. And because they couldn't hold on to it, that's when you start to think, all right, we got just beat up on Cobblestone. And now we were given a golden opportunity to really make a big impact on the first half of train here, and we still can't make it work. And at that point, you've got to wonder, well, what does it take, you know? How much of a win are we going to need to actually pull ahead in this game? Because that's, I don't know, like, if you can't build some sort of momentum based on a round like that, I can't even think what it'll take.
The perfect bait and switch there by Getright. He's getting another kill with that MAC-10. Two kills for him, that's 1,200 bucks on top of the win bonus. A lot of money being made there, but again, Getright baits. He spends all of his bullets, he runs around the corner, and unfortunately, you have Pyth, you know, holding the angle. So no joy for Optic here. But now Optic, after the two rounds of eco, clearly this is why they wanted to just, you know, save up as much money as possible. They have the double AWP strat that they tried to put into play on Cobblestone. It wasn't super effective on Cobblestone, unfortunately for them. But on train, it can work. You can have one over on that B site, one on the A site. Really try and split the map up between the two sniper rifles. So we'll see if it actually pans out here for Optic.
And both Nafly and Mixwell were doing a decent job on Cobblestone, at least with the AWP. They were hitting some shots, so I don't think this is necessarily a bad idea. Pyth going to be moving in. Not getting spotted by anyone yet. He's getting a lot of free space to move around with, and this is a big problem. Here goes the first spray. Mixwell going to be going down. Stannis next in line, and almost a triple there, but Rush going to put an end to it and tries to cross back in. That must have been an impressive shot from Forrest's point of view, and it's going to be Naf and Daps left, but I think it should never be the case that Pyth can walk that far in without getting spotted. There should always at least be someone calling it out that, wait a minute, he might be behind that first train, and they just didn't know.
Well, I mean, this is one of NIP's favorite plays to go for. If it isn't Pyth, it's Forrest, who's working his way out there, just getting out through A main aggressively. This round, Forrest had the AWP, so he did not, I mean, he wasn't just like running out there. That came down to Pyth, but they always tend to do this. If they aren't putting, like, if the way that they play on that A site, right, NIP, is like, if they aren't putting three over by alley early on in the round, they're trying to put somebody out through A main very quickly to create some space, some room to move with there on the A site. So everything works out as planned here for NIP, and Optic, at least they can save an AWP, they can save a sniper rifle. So they've got that going for them. It's not a whole lot, but it's something. Forrest has got to be careful, though. There can be somebody lurking around that corner.
Yeah, don't want to give up any free AWP rifles there, but it works out just well enough. 5-3 right now, and T-side train is supposed to be the more difficult one, and they're in the lead, Semler. Mm-hmm. And Optic, they're done with saving. They saved a couple of rifles, and they're going to buy it for the rest, and can't really blame them. I mean, I think they want to make a real impact right now.
I mean, this is where it really comes down to, right, for them. It's just they know they're the massive underdogs. They're playing like the underdogs right now. They're not playing as if they have nothing to lose, though, and that's the main problem here. So, like, they're clearly taking this a bit too seriously. They're a little bit too stiff. They need to actually get in here and look to take the fight with NIP. Well, Pyth is going to shut down Stanislaw, so that is actually not the start that Optic were looking for. And Forrest catches out Rush out in the open on the A site. Still two players here, but as I say it, Nafly gets caught by Getright, and really it's just NIP who are showing no respect. They're charging out there like they've got nothing to lose, just looking for these duels because they know that they've got Optic just broken right now. Their mental game, Optic, it isn't there. Boom.
Exist going to be closing out that round, and it seemed like Optic weren't even going to try and put up any kind of a fight. Forrest and Pyth, I think, opening up that round actually on Stannis. So, just generally speaking, a very, very good start here for NIP. We do have Forrest currently top fragging with 10 kills, but it's not like anybody else on NIP isn't doing well.
Yeah.
6 on Exist and Getright, and Pyth and Freiburg with 8 and 7. So, all in all, things are looking quite good.
Stanislaw is the one who's struggling a little bit here for Optic, sitting on 2 kills at the, you know, going into the 10th round. Not exactly the best scoreline, but we'll see if he can wake up at any point. Maybe not this round, considering they actually have another eco here on their table, Optic. It's just like Cobble all over again. NIP, once they manage to get control of their opponent's economy, Optic, it's just so difficult for them to get their legs back under them. Actually have the money to properly play a CT side, where you really do need the money for the grenades.
Well, right now, we are in the 10th round, and I mean, again, these deagles on train are actually not too bad. Long range, you could definitely get some shots in with it, but the question always is, without the armor, I mean, if you take any bullets in return, that fight is going to end almost immediately. And look at the emphasis on the Molotovs here, clearing out all the most likely spots. So if anyone's holding close, it's going to be just a bad time. Daps going to be checked in that corner, and Stannis, no luck with the deagle either.
Just brutal. A brutal shutdown coming in here, and it's a thing of beauty. NIP, they are not cutting corners. They know, right, you guys are on pistols, you're not going to have any nades, you're not going to have anything to really mess up our execute, so we're just going to go for a crisp, clean execute, all of the nades going out into the likely spots. And you saw there was a man, didn't catch his name, but he was holding very close. It's just like, Exist, that's going to be one of the first spots that he checks, because he knows that all of the other spots that are about like halfway from the site, behind the bomb train, behind the other trains, they've all been cleared out by Molotovs. So all he has to do is just run around and just whip to the right, check the close angles, and the round is NIP's, and a perfect anti-eco round coming in here. So after that bumpy start, where they gave Optic a chance, NIP have just got the lockdown going now on these anti-eco rounds. They are not leaving anything up to chance. And yeah, there we go, it's Daps who's holding close to the spools.
Yeah, and that's normally a very good position, actually, to be holding that. It's kind of hard to check if you're on the terrorist side, but not when they have all the Molotovs down, because all the Molotovs are checking every other position, so there's only really a couple left, and Daps was one of them, so that's why it's also worth it for NIP to throw all of those grenades in there. Right now, we're at 7-3, and moving into the 11th round, and NIP, look at the equipment they have, and the money is what's ridiculous. They got so much in the bank, and Optic most definitely don't.
Yeah. And once again, putting 3 over here towards Ali. So, this might get tricky here for Naf. Smoke is down, he hasn't spotted anybody, but he is falling back. Pyth gets caught by Stanislaw, caught on the ladder there, but the opening kill not going to go Getright's way. Finally, things are coming alive here. Naf with the second kill, and then Daps peeking in, drops the bomb carrier. So it's all on Forrest now. He does find 2 kills, but he's down to half HP, and he has to make his way all the way over towards the entrance of Alley to be able to pick up that bomb. Minute 14 left on this clock, though, so he does have some time to play with.
I mean, there is no way to lose a round like this except through sheer incompetence, which, I mean, I wouldn't rule it out, but it should never happen. Winning a 1-on-3 in a situation like this only happens if the other team allows you to do it.
Yes.
If they sort of start making mistakes and...
Yeah, there we go, Forrest.
The one thing is, the bomb is all the way back there.
He's changing it up. He's going towards Pop Dog. I was worried he might just try and run straight out A main, right? Just go for the straightforward approach. That's where Mixwell would be waiting for him. Instead, he's going up. He's going to go through Pop Dog and really try and change up this angle.
Yeah, that might catch them off guard, but again, I think the clock here is the really big thing for Forrest. If he had a minute now, he could play around with this for so long, but it's definitely not going to be easy. That smoke might give away his position a little bit. He's up on the train, and now they definitely hear him, so they know where he is. 19 seconds, Forrest. He could have got that shot on Daps, but it's Mixwell taking him out from behind, and it will be 7-4. Optic finally coming up with a bit of a round here.
Wow, excellent work there between the two of them.
Yeah, Daps and Nef fly down at Ivy or the back hallways there. Definitely a good job.
Well, let's see what's going to happen, because now they actually got donated an AWP by Forrest. So they have the double AWP set up once again. Stanislaw's got that Swag 7, but that's fine if he holds up close. Plenty of positions on train to play that shotgun from. And it does look like they want to go ultra-aggressive towards A main. They want to shut down one of NIP's favorite plays, which is to get that man out there early. Now that they finally have some nades, some anti-rush nades, Optic taking the fight to NIP. And then Stanislaw getting right into Pop Dog, JW style. He's got that shotgun, he's going to be holding up close, and Rush is there to open things up. He takes out Forrest, but NIP aren't letting up. They're going to go charging out onto the B site.
Get right playing on the bomb site itself, but look at the flank coming through here. Stannis is there with the Mag 7, and they're trying to get this bomb plant down, but it shouldn't be possible. Freiburg once and twice, and it's not going to be a bomb plant, but it's still man lead here for Optic. Mixwell and Rush coming in with some really good kills, and Pyth all on his own, 1v4 at the moment. Just trying to see if maybe he could do a bit more damage. We're nearing the end of the first half right now. And I mean, the way that things are going, Optic, they need to keep all the rifles alive here. They can't afford to let anything go.
Yeah, they have to cross their fingers and hope that Pyth is going to get the drop on him. He shouldn't. He's trying to bait out the shot there from Mixwell, but it's great trigger control from Mixwell. Does not take the bait, doesn't go for the shoulder peek. Just waits for Pyth to fully commit to that angle and shuts him down. Nafly actually has dropped from the server, though, so we should have a quick technical pause coming in here. But this actually works a little bit because for Optic now, this counts as a little bit of a second timeout. Although, I don't know, we might be going live because he does get back into the server in the nick of time.
Yeah, so we'll see if he's going to get the round bonus or anything like that. We'll definitely be right on it. But I mean, at the moment, with the way that this game is progressing, I guess you could say it's sort of marginally better than it was on Cobblestone. They're getting more rounds in here and there. But they're still not doing a great job.
No, they are definitely struggling right now with the NIP offense. And NIP just showing that they really aren't, they really don't have much respect for Optic with how they're playing this out. I mean, they did learn respect in the anti-ecos, which is what the big thing to take away from this. They haven't really given Optic a chance to get the drop on them because NIP are making very good use of their nades in those sorts of rounds, right? But in the buy rounds is when we really need to see Optic step up. And this is it, this one round right now, the 13th, 7-5, NIP in the lead. But now's Optic's time to shine. They have the double off setup once again. Everybody has rifles. They have the anti-rush nades. They have everything they need here to shut NIP out of it.
Oh, Rush trying for it, but the flashbangs is preventing the kill on Freiburg. There's a good shot. And oh, what a headshot. That was mid-air. Forrest going to be going out of the round, and Rush finally taken out from on top of that train. But the bomb has been planted, and it's still a 3-on-4. That's a great shot from Getright taking out Stanislaw. And now back to a 3-on-3. Bit of a fight here as Nafly is going to be going down. And if you notice, no one else from Optic was ready to push behind that. No one could have capitalized on the fact that GetRub is looking a different way. Now they're just playing a 2v3 and are a little bit probably sad that they don't have Nafly in the round still. Daps here close to the train and Mixwell pushing forward. And they're going to go down simultaneously.
Just brutal. And you're absolutely right to point that out as well. It's just when it comes to these retakes, somebody jumps the gun. Somebody seems to try and get in there to make the play instead of playing as a unit, playing together. Because you can't be going from, you know, a two-man lead in the round to somehow allowing NIP to just pick you apart. And this play here from Nap, I mean, he just steps out. He had the angle as well. He had the advantage in that fight, and he still misses the shot. When you have that AWP, it's so unforgiving. You miss that first shot, you're just dead most of the time because it takes so long to get the second shot ready. So Optic now, well, they are holding a little bit aggressive here towards lower ramp. Flash is going to go through, though. Pyth takes point. But NIP right now, they're just making noise over here on B. They want to sow confusion in the ranks. They want to make sure that Optic don't get comfortable.
And Mixwell was actually ready to push up where that smoke is, where he's scoping up right now. He wanted to play at that corner and not this far back, and he wanted to have Daps on the crossfire. So already sort of the initial idea for Optic is there, but they actually give up on it because of one flash and one smoke. You know, you sort of almost wish that they were a bit more persistent. Maybe try and force some of these fights a little bit more.
Oh, nice pop flash. The second one just completely catches out Stanislav. He's going to get run down by Pyth. A little bit of a stack there. That was a little awkward, but they do manage to get the trade kill. And it's down to Naf, who will get picked off by Forest. Two-man advantage now for NIP. Bomb has been planted in Optic. Pretty easy decision, actually, for them at this point. Back off, save the guns, cross your fingers, and hope you can get something done in the 15th round, because it's not gonna happen. You just are not going to be able to pull off a 2v4 retake on that A site versus a fired-up NIP. This is just brutal.
Yeah, this has gone way out of control. We've got 8 rounds right now for NIP, and it's about to be a 9th here. The bomb is ticking down. And if you look at the scoreboard, I mean, right now, NIP just leading all the way, pretty much. Mixwell still doing fairly well, and Rush at 10. But apart from that, Optic just aren't getting enough kills. Their aim's just not right. Leads you to ask the question, Semler. Are Optic in need of an optician so they can see the NIP play?
Clearly, they need new optics, right?
You think that could be a thing? I'm not sure.
Why not? Something
has gone horribly wrong on this Optic team. It's just not working out.
No, they're just... It's that underdog situation, right? They haven't convinced themselves that they have nothing to lose going up against NIP. They're playing scared, and that's the main issue. If you give NIP all of the room to work with on the map, it's not going to pan out, because NIP, they're just going to keep getting in position. They're going to keep rinsing and repeating. Optic, you know, they're trying, like, what? It was at the beginning of the half where they had a player, Stanislav, I believe, who was holding up close in Brown Halls. But they're not pushing Alley very often. Finally, now, in this round, they figure it out, Optic. They're like, right, we need to go aggressive somewhere. And so NaFly has pushed out aggressive on Alley. Finally, they actually get out there and try and take the fight to NIP, because a lot of this has just been Optic, you know, kind of sitting around on the sites, waiting to get run over.
Yeah, and Forrest's going to be coming back in here. He was jumping and skipping for a while, but now he's actually scoped up. Got no clue that NaFly is right on top of him, and that's an easy kill. Trying to follow it up here. He's taking a fight with Freiburg. Wish he could take that rifle that's right across, but... I mean, it really feels like Optic are only making these plays once it's too late. Once they actually have almost nothing to lose and they think, well, this is gone anyway, I'm just going to try and do something. And that's almost the mentality they need at the beginning of the round. Freiburg. Oh, man. Detective Freiburg on the case saying, wait a minute, there are rifles dropping from this ladder and we don't have any players there. Maybe, just maybe, there's a player on the ladder. Naf is going to be alone, jumping down, heroic play, but not going to work out. 10-5 in favor of NIP.
Yeah, everything going according to plan here for the Ninjas. Really not too much to write home about as far as Optic are concerned. We kind of touched on it towards the end there. Lack of aggression, lack of, well, basically teaching NIP that you have to respect us.
Yeah.
NIP just felt like they could run around and do what they wanted.
Well, I mean, it goes both ways. You were saying NIP don't really respect Optic, but I think Optic respect NIP way too much. I mean, they're not making any real plays. Mixwell and NaFly have sort of been trying, but mostly it happens at the end of the half. You know, when they're so far behind, they realize it's already gone. They need to start the half with that kind of a mentality and just try and take some of these fights versus NIP. When we get back for the second half, we're gonna have to see if Optic can actually manage that. They're very far behind, and we'll be back soon. Well, it is the second map of the second week here at E-League, and also the second half of that map here between Optic and NIP. And so far, things haven't really been working out for Mixwell and crew.
No, it's been a very straightforward kind of two maps that we've had so far. Cobblestone, just fully Nip. It was the Nip show, and we're getting more of the same here on Train. Both maps actually had a bit of a back and forth at the beginning, but it's always been, I mean, in both cases, it's been Optic caving at, when it gets into that, you know, just brawl, and then NIP run away with the first half. So not really sure what's going to be in store for us here now that Optic Gaming get to start on the T side. They're going to be the ones, you know, aiming to get that pistol. But like on Cobblestone, NIP, CT side, they just went full out aggressive. But what is this?
Yeah. Is that Mixwell? I think that was what we were told anyway. Someone spotting out Mixwell watching at in Columbus, maybe. So
for some reason, that looks like Bialy to me.
Sorry.
That looks like Bialy to me for some reason.
Well,
I mean, am I crazy?
I like the idea that that the players watch each other play. I feel like too often, whenever you lose a game or you're not playing yourself, players just tend to sort of disappear and go somewhere else, right?
Yeah.
So maybe getting a bit of inspiration.
What blows my mind is that there's like pictures of like Cold Zero with Fallen, you know, like fan pictures where Cold Zero is clearly like fanboying out, and now he's like the best player in the world, right? It's like, okay, that was only like what, 3-4 years ago. That is nuts. Shows you what's possible.
Yeah, I mean, in Counter-Strike time, 3 or 4 years, not necessarily that much. It could take people a lot of time to get to a high level in this game. Now we got Optic on the terrorist side on the second half here, trying to charge out is Mixwell. And again, he's been in charge of trying to make a lot of these plays. He's going to be getting a kill there, but otherwise, it's all Forest and it's all headshots. Three of them right now looking for a fourth at the moment. Forest actually gets disconnected after all of that. So a little bit of a shame. But Freiburg going to be taking down Daps, and that will be a very clean round here for NIP.
That will be 5 headshots.
Yeah.
Basically. Just, you know, get wrecked, Optic. Like, what can you do? They even, I mean, they did go for the no fear approach, right, Optic? They just charged out straight onto that A site. They had a strategy clearly in mind there with the smokes. And so it comes down to them at least just getting, like, one kill to help them out. You know, just rush onto the site and hope that you catch somebody out. The only problem is that Forest just hit nothing but headshots. So when that happens, when that CT side, that USP comes into play, and it's just like pew pew lasers, boom, headshots everywhere, what are you going to do if you're on the T side? There isn't a whole lot, especially once your nades are starting to clear up as well, the smokes, etc.
Yeah, and it's a shame because once Mixwell is out there, he becomes the main focus, and it should leave some space for the rest of the team to walk out. But I mean, they just weren't able to do that at all. So just a little bit like on Cobblestone, you know, once NIP win this pistol round, you start to wonder, what is there any way back, you know? Because if Optic had any illusions of building a strong comeback, you would think that had to start with a pistol round in the second half.
Yeah, they're fading fast right now. And, well, I mean, we should be getting back live into the game. Force is back on the server, so we should be good to go. But it is going to be a force buy coming out from Optic. And no bomb plant. This is kind of standard fare. You know, terrorist side, they're just thinking, right, okay, we didn't get a bomb plant. We're in a double eco scenario where that means we have to save back-to-back. So we'll just, you know, spend some money in this round and see what we can do. Hopefully, we can actually try and catch NIP off guard. The thing is, though, is that NIP, like I said, at the beginning of the first half, I think they learned their lesson to actually, you know, not throw away rounds versus pistols. So I think it should be the same thing here on their CT side. They should not be giving this round over to Optic.
Yeah, and Train is also one of those maps when you're on the CT side, you can play very defensive against what's coming here. They could be really far away and just rely on a couple of grenades to make life really hard for Optic. So I think it's going to be tough for the American team to catch NIP off guard, you know, like, how do they get close enough to make these pistols work?
It could be as simple as you either have like that inner site rush, the B site, right, where you just kind of just all YOLO down and hope that you get lucky. But then there's the other approach, which is you put everybody through alley. And you put 3 guys over there, and you just kind of hope you can just like run and gun down whoever's holding over there. But there's Forest on your screen, one of the oldest players still in, well, in the CSGO scene, but also just like one of the god tier legends from 1.6, the game, you know, the version of the game before this one.
Just look at that face. I'm starting to believe that it is impossible to get a shot of Forest's face where he doesn't have that grin and that smile in his eyes, you know? I bet they asked him, try and look serious, you know, try and look like you're ready to fight, you know, and that's the most he can do is like...
It's more like, you know, he's just like, yeah, I mean, you know, anybody who knows Forrest, when you see that grin, you know you're about to get wrecked. So that is him looking tough, right, Forrest?
But, yeah, again, just not that tough. But in the game, it's something quite different. Maybe you wouldn't know it by looking at his face, but he's an absolute monster. And you saw on Cobblestone just a terrifying display of of skill, and it's continued onto this map. So that's definitely not a good time.
He's also one of the biggest trolls in the scene. Just saying. Like, trolls just, you know, loves jokes, practical jokes, awesome guy to hang around.
This is true, and I think we might try and touch on this topic later on, but one of the really disturbing things about Forest is that he's sort of a natural not just to playing Counter-Strike, but at actually all video games. He can touch almost any game and become good at it within the span of a couple of days or weeks, mm-hmm. Which is obviously very annoying. Everyone
very annoying
hates people like
us.
That.
Yeah, it's like Top Gun from the Australian scene, right? You know, same thing. He played in the Asian Minor at the beginning of the year, hadn't touched the game for like a year and a half, nearly 2 years, played as if he'd never stopped playing. You know, just like, oh, yeah, guys, I'm back. You know, just
not sure I would compare Top Gun to Forest, but...
I'm talking about this really annoying ability some players have to like just completely like either just get into games very quickly, right, and start playing at a high level, or just, you know, it's like their skill just doesn't go away. You know, they can take a break for a year, they come back, and they're still hitting headshots. Like,
but I mean, Forest even took a break. I mean, even for a while when he was playing a lot of Dota 2, I think he was standing in for some of the sort of Swedish Dota 2 teams. Whenever they needed like a stand-in, then Forrest would be playing in there. I'm not saying that Forrest couldn't necessarily have a Dota 2 career instead, but
no.
But I wouldn't actually rule it out that if he really wanted to go all in on it, I could see that being a real thing.
Oh, absolutely.
Guys just got a mind for video games.
Freiburg exists like that. I believe them. Well, not so much exist, but Freiburg and Force are very into the Dota 2 scene. They're always like when they're sitting at the airport, all that sort of stuff. You know, they're watching streams on their tablets, you know, keeping up to date with the Dota 2 leagues that are constantly happening as well alongside the CSGO leagues. So, I mean, yeah, it's cool to see. I mean, there's just a real long history with Forrest.
Now, of course, finally, we're getting him sucked into Clash Royale, so things are going to get real bad for Forrest. He doesn't know it yet, but for sure that's going to be a problem.
All right, guys. So the reason why we have a bit of a pause here is that because Forrest dropped out of the server before the end of the round, he didn't get his loss bonus. He didn't get his money, basically. And so right now they're just trying to restore the money real quick, make sure that he can, get what's his, right?
Get that money.
Get that money.
Yes, indeed. Train, I mean, right now, Get Right, who was obviously top fragging on Cobblestone, and yeah, it still is, and it's always been a sign of trouble when both Forrest and Get Right are playing well.
That's always been
what you want to avoid if you're playing them.
Exactly, right? That's always been a big power, I mean, a powerhouse combo for NIP. When they dominated when the roster was first put together, it was just, you know, the Forrest and Get Right show. Get Right in particular, I mean, the guy was a monster, still is. But really, you know, when NIP shine, it's, you know, Freiburg is hitting his entry frags, right? He's the first man onto the site, and he's opening things up. But then you have Force and you have Get Right that are just, you know, that powerhouse duo coming in and just picking up kill after kill.
Now, here's an interesting sort of spin on all of this, because I think most people would have predicted, except for Mo, obviously, but everyone else would have predicted that NIP was probably going to win this one 2-0. Now, later on today, they're going to be playing G2, and the thing is, now NIP have already been tested on these two maps. So G2, they could sit around and look at it and think, all right, we know a little bit about how Train works for this current version of NIP and their current form on it. You know, maybe we see something we haven't seen before. It's always a bit of an edge to watch your opponents play later on. And you've got to think in this group, it is G2 and NIP that are sort of the titans of the group.
Yes.
Well, going into it here, we're just going to sort out any kind of tech issues, but Forrest, he should be back on the server. When we come back, we're going to continue with the second half here between NIP and Optic on Train. We'll be right back. And we're back at it here. We've got Train coming up, and after a bit of a technical slip up, Forrest just taking a brief vacation in the middle of the match. He's now back into it here, and NIP, they're winning pretty hard. So, I mean, right now for Optic, it's going to be painful having to continue to wait until you finally get knocked out.
Right? I mean, you're just drawing out the agony.
At some point, you're just waiting for your coach to throw in that towel. Let it end, please. Just
and
stop
then,
it.
You know, it's like, where's threat? That's actually holding back that arm, you know, like, no, 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 let it go, let it go.
Well, Forrest and Mixwell have been playing pretty well on Train at the moment. You see there, Forrest with 9 kills and 9 deaths. That's terrifying. But considering how far behind they are, it's still pretty impressive that Mixwell is doing as well as he is. And that was the same on Cobblestone where they were, you know, like 10 rounds down. Mixwell is still getting some good frags in there. So a lot of respect to him for keeping his head in the game, as it were.
Yeah, it's just difficult for Mixwell. I mean, Forrest, they've got money for days. He gets his off whenever he wants it. Mixwell, it's constantly that, okay, like, can I afford to get my AWP? How much do I have to save to be able to get it? He's constantly having to play with this in his head. And if he had, like, mad money, just big bank, he could sit there and just op for days. But right now, that's been the story of this of these two maps for Optic. It's just that NIP keep controlling their economy, and so they never really have the money to go for full nades. They never really have the money to go for that double AWP setup. And when they do, they only get it for like one round before NIP run over them again.
The Spanish scene is actually sort of a weird one because it's almost never talked about, but they do have some talent down there, and Mixwell obviously being one of them. They've got Musambani as well, who is a big thing in 1.6. Yeah. I haven't quite seen the same of him go, but actually, watching him play is not uninteresting, and his sort of tactical input is also a little bit interesting. So I definitely wish that we could see a little bit more of him. And there's this other player that I keep wanting to
there
bring
he
up.
Is.
All right, yeah, down front and center.
That's the one. That's the big picture, right? You know, watching. I think it was watching Cloud9. But yeah, Mixwell, you spot him.
Reddit detective stepping up. That's a good job there.
He's got a bit of that Forrest eyebrow game too going, you know.
But there's another Spanish player called Aguilar who we haven't seen for a long time, but actually for like 2 years plus, I think.
Yeah,
so maybe I should stop bringing him up. But I mean, the fact is there is some talent in the Spanish scene. Can't just, I think, completely cut them out. So it's exciting that that one of them has got a chance to play internationally. Now, whether or not this particular Optic fairy tale that's been going on is going to continue, I don't know, but for sure Mixwell has created some real estate for himself, right? People are looking at him now and saying, well, whatever else happens to Optic, we got to keep our eye on Mixwell.
Yeah, and it's a bit disappointing just to not see that level from Rush actually, you know, showing up. I mean, he is getting into the double digits as far as the frags are concerned. He is still having an impact, but you know, we aren't quite seeing it. There we have Mixwell on your screen though, age 20, role entry fragger.
These young kids,
really.
Professional players at 20, kind of hard to imagine.
I mean, look at us, you know, we're old, Anders, you know, it's just like, just doesn't, reflexes aren't there,
old.
Need a cane to make our way around the studio.
Old and also not professional players. There's
yeah.
A lot of things that we shouldn't try and compare with these people, but this is one of the interesting things, and actually one of the issues that the European landscape has is that you can have a lot of talent, but if you have the so-called language barrier, right? If you're from Spain and your English is maybe not good enough to go to America or go to somewhere else and play, that could be a real problem. And I think there could be players who might have been stuck in that. You know, people were talking about it a little bit with
Alu.
Yeah, with Alu. Alu, I think it's probably, but maybe with someone like Oscar.
Right.
Where you think, could he fit into an international lineup? When Simple was here playing with Liquid, that might be the most obvious example. You know, where people say, well, he's from Ukraine, you know, how much is he going to be able to communicate with the team? Now, we never really officially were told that that was sort of the big problem, and there may have been too many other problems overshadowing everything, but it certainly is a challenge, right?
You have Guardian, who's also like learned Russian just to be able to play with Na'Vi, right? You know, like there is a history for it. Alu struggled with, you know, it for NIP, and you know, since we're talking about NIP, let's go ahead and take a look at this feature that we have on GetRight.
My nickname is GetRight. I'm playing for Ninjas in Pyjamas.
GetRight! Oh, he gets all 3 kills! Looking for what's the call! That's the edge! GetRight! Shutting it down!
I'm from Stockholm, in a little city called Spånga. Our biggest rivals right now is probably Fnatic, who are Swedish comrades. I think Swedes are so good on Counter-Strike because we have long winters.
The Swedes have always had either the best team or one of the best Counter-Strike teams in the world.
Getright wasn't just the best lurker, he was the best player in the entire game.
Getright getting one, headshot!
Getright brings a lot of passion to the game, and he's super dedicated to winning.
They gave me the most difficult task, and I feel 100% confident to win those touches to win the game.
He encouraged all other in the team to really perform to 100% each and every single game.
One role model I had before when I was younger was Hedon, which is one of my best friends and also the creator of NIP. When I'm in a really big, intense game, I actually feel really, really nervous. You have to just take a big breath and just relax and close your eye for that millisecond and just be prepared for the battles that come up for you.
Yeah, well, there it is. And also, one thing the feature didn't mention, one of the most lovable people, I think, in the scene. Very easygoing guy. But again, I mean, this maybe also just be a Swedish thing, but how they act and how they are on a personal level outside of the game, it seems that it's like a huge mismatch with how aggressive and skilled they are in the game, you know? You don't think of them as like ruthless killers, you know, when you just meet them, but they are very good and they're extremely focused, have really hard to beat.
It's just that, you know, Getright is just, he is just that figurehead of CS. He hasn't done anything apart from CS, basically. You know, from a kid, this was his first job. You know, I'm going to be a pro CS player, and he's been doing it ever since. So he's been around for ages, and he's been playing at a top-tier level for ages.
Yeah, and it's true. I mean, look at the history as well. We're talking in 2000 there when NIP were founded originally in a sort of original form with Poddy in there. And they mentioned Heaton in that lineup, and for good reason, obviously, also a legendary name of the game. But if you talk to Heaton, he will say, I learned almost everything I know from Poddy. Mm-hmm. He was actually one of the sort of the core members there, and also a really funny guy. Now, we are going to get back into it. We did sort out the issues. Of course, we do apologize for any kind of delay, but here it goes. 11-5 right now. NIP with a very big lead, and with the money here on Optic, I mean, things are just not looking good for them at the moment. I can't even think of a scenario in which NIP could not win this game. I feel like it's destined to be.
It's written in stone. You got a hold of Moses' tablets, you know, back in the green room there. And one of the rules was NIP will not lose to Optic on train.
I would like, we should do that more. Moses and the stone tablets. Definitely.
I mean, right now it is just, I mean, this pause is not really going to help things for Optic just because it's giving them time to dwell. Whereas NIP, you know, they just get to, they're just confident. They know that they're going to get back in here and just start wrecking again, right?
Optic, you know what happened the first time Moses came off the mountain with the stone tablets and he found out that the villagers had built a golden calf and he destroyed the tablets and killed everyone in all of the neighboring villages? That's actually true, and I think that Moses has that kind of temper. I mean, the Moses here in the studio, I think there's some... The name, I don't know if he thought about that when he picked it, but that's a good analogy there. He could get a little bit upset when things... Have you seen him play Clash Royale?
Oh, yeah. Not only that, but it's like, you know, him coming to the analyst desk, I think all of the, you know, the fans, they looked up, they said, finally, somebody from North America, an analyst on the desk. And he said, no, your hope... It is all over. It just crushed all of their hopes and dreams, basically, because he's been doing nothing but wreck North American teams since he joined, which is always why it's a little bit funny when people are like, well, he's biased for North America. It's just
thinking,
actually, boys.
What you're saying is they're all thinking maybe he will lead us to the promised land, Europe, but that's not going to happen, not on Moses' watch. Well, we do have the countdown in action here, and it seems like we're actually going to be replaying the pistol round.
Yeah, replaying it exactly. They're going to recreate the pistol round, and, sometimes this is just how it plays out.
Yeah, so on a technical note, and if you are a new player watching and just not sure what's going on here, I mean, sometimes what's called a match medic could be a little bit tricky if people disconnect at the wrong time. So what they're going to do here is basically get the kills that they would have got in the pistol round, and that way they just sort of manually recreate the round. So pretty easy stuff, I think. Forrest is supposed to get the last headshot here on Daps, who's obviously being a bit of a troll. So there we go, recreating the pistol round, and now we're gonna go into the second round, second half, second week of E-League. This first game is definitely interesting. Second game is gonna be interesting, but the real game, Semler, it's going to be NIP and G2.
Buddy. That's happening tonight. The last two maps of the night here on the first day of Group B here at E-League. I mean, yeah, you're talking about two monster teams from Europe, and they're going to clash two maps. It's going to be so sick. And to be frank, they are the teams that we expect to make it to that best of three finals on Friday night playing on TBS. It would be a massive upset, I think, for either of the North American teams in this group to take them out. So we'll all be waiting to see just how well they're going to perform here, what kind of shape they're bringing to the table now that, you know, they're playing here in North America in a live studio.
Yes, and I mean, I think out of the two American teams, probably Optic was the one that we were expecting maybe could have an impact here. Mm-hmm. I think Selfless, everyone, maybe except you, Sam, everyone else has sort of ridden them off a little bit. So
yeah.
Not going to happen.
Still best of ones, right? And
that's true.
That can get tricky. We're talking about a group phase where you're going to play two maps against all of the opponents out there, so a total of six maps possible. Liquid, unfortunately, went 0-6. Luminosity went 6-0. And so we'll see if, you know, Selfless, can they do one better than Hiko and Liquid?
Oh, we're going to find out later on here. Good trade back from Mixwell, actually, picking up the shot and taking out Exist. And now the rest of Optic going to try and make their way onto the bomb side. The bomb is coming down from Ivy, in fact, and running their way into the bomb side. They need this kill on Jet Ryder, and that's going to be successful. Long range shot there with the FAMAS from Pyth. Going to try and see if he can get a kill and the bomb. Daps, he wants to put it down, but he can't until he wins this fight. And that's going to be a good start, at least. He's still sort of sandwiched in and going for more fights. Daps doing a very good job in this round. The one thing is, I don't think they realize the Pyth is this far up. That's the bomb down, and Rush is on 7 health.
Yeah, it's not looking good for him. There's a little bit of a pop flash. Pyth really trying to flashes himself, too. You know, getting a little ahead of himself there. Really wanted to take that fight and see if he could catch Rush off guard, but it's not going to happen. Instead, it's Rush. He's got an M4 now, but he has to plant that bomb. And Pyth played that perfectly because he ran down that clock. There just was no time for Rush to play any games there, to try and go for the fake plant, anything of the sort. Just instantly goes for the bomb plant because there's only like 10 seconds left. So this is Daps. He picked up that M4. He was actually making a big difference. Two key frags going his way. I think that last one on Freiburg was like the last bullet as well in that gun. So cutting it a bit close, but he makes it work. Still, 12-5, NIP in the lead, Optic on pistols, and we'll see now.
Yeah, you know what, and I just realized in our break here, a lot of Spanish people have been tweeting me saying, what about Lowell? Why are you forgetting about Lowell? And that is a good point. I don't want to keep Lowell out of it. He's a very good player as well. So, yeah, shout out to him, and thanks for reminding me. Get Right here looking on top of the smoke as Rush is going to walk past it. Get Right, what are you doing? There's a shot that we needed from the beginning, and coming up from behind. Oh, no! Forrest getting one more shot. He's going to get the third one, too. Almost a quad kill with a max 7. What a slaughter. Optic getting ripped apart. Torn limb from limb by that max 7 shotgun. And Get Right. Well, he started off with a bit of a failed shot, but Forrest showing him how it's done.
Yeah, and what's even better for NIP is that both of the rifle carriers exist and Pyth don't get any kills. It's all the shotguns and the SMGs just making so much money in this round for NIP. You get bonus money for kills with those weapons. So, I mean, it's perfect. Forrest, he gets 3 kills. It's just like, great, money for days. He spent all of it this round, but still, 5,500. And well, I mean, it is looking very good here for NIP. So good that Freiburg is staying on the MP7 and Get Right staying on the shotgun. So, interesting decision here for the CT side.
Yeah, they don't feel much fear. Get Right pushing through, and this time is so much better. Rush and Daps caught not really paying attention, and it's the same smoke as last time, so it should have been an indication that maybe someone was going to be there.
Yeah.
And even Get Right even survives that engagement. It's ridiculous.
It's good that you point that out, though, because in general, what you expect is for the guy to be on the edge of the smoke towards the left, and so that's where both the Optic players are watching. They're waiting for Get Right to try and jump up on the rail. Get Right, though, he's just like, actually, I'm a step ahead of you again. I'm only going to run right through it, get right between the two of you, and a third headshot kill here for Get Right. Stanislaw will drop, and it's down to Naf and Mixwell, the last two alive here for Optic. NIP know where they're coming from as well. They hear the nade stepping in, and there's the big spray coming in from Exist. He drops Naf down to 14 HP, picks off Mixwell, and this is pretty much it. Optic, what can they really hope to do here? Not a whole lot, apart from, you know, give Get Right a quad kill at the end of the round. 14-5.
Yeah, a bit of a shame that that last kill for Get Right wasn't also with the Max 7. You're trying to see if he could do better than Forrest in the Max 7 Olympics, but he did actually get the third one in this one. Seized the gun barrel on Stan, and that will be the end of it. What a brutal round. And again, this adds to Optic's current feeling. I'm assuming, I can't obviously read their minds, but basically they've got to be feeling like nothing we do works. But there's no way to win this, you know? Everywhere we go, we're just gonna get shut down before we even set up, you know.
Mm-hmm. Oh, And there we go. This is the kind of aggression that I was talking about that we weren't really seeing from Optic. Pyatees goes all the way out into Alley. Nafly will end up finding the one dig headshot on him. And then exists a little bit late to the party. That allows Stanislaw to pick up that AWP and save it. So it does give Optic something to work with here in this round. But then Daps and Rush both get caught, and it is down to a 2v4 here for Naf and Stanislaw. But that's the difference. It's like aggression in Brown Halls from Get Right. Pyatees going aggressive at Alley. You know, the CT side on the European side just doesn't stop working. It's always going to try and push and find a weakness in the T offense. What? Yeah, just throw it away. Just throw it away, Naf. What was that? Through the smoke.
Yeah. What's great is it sort of looked like he lined it up as well, but NIP, they got him boxed in with the bomb, and it's a bit of a shooting gallery here. And Naf trying his best, but not going to be happening. It will be 15-5 here, and NIP just absolutely wrecking Optic on this map.
YOLO.
Oh, he missed that jump, Forrest.
Nobody saw that, Forrest.
We all saw. And we're all judging.
Yeah, we're all judging. countdown has begun to get into potentially the last round of this first map, or the second map, rather. 15-5, NIP have 10 match points. So quite a bit of time here to work with. Optic, they will have the money to go for the AKs, the nades. And well, they aren't wasting any time. It's going to go straight up rush onto the A site, where there are currently four players here ready to hold for NIP.
Well, I like the change of pace here. And Mixwell trying to create some space for his team, actually going very aggressive. But Forrest and Freiberg going to get the opening frags. Daps and Netfly with a bit of a return. Daps trying for that bomb plant very early on, and that will be successful.
Yeah, no time wasted at all. I do like it. Forrest getting a little over-aggressive there as well, trying to hunt down Daps, who was probably got called by a teammate that, you know, he was headshot. So looking for the easy kill. He gets punished. And now life gets just a little bit more interesting here for NIP. Nice nade onto Pyth just to tag him up, but Daps is waiting right around the corner. He has spotted out Get Right. So a little bit of information to go off of. They know that there's a man holding on the bomb site itself. But Exist, he's checking upper, and now he's got that high ground advantage. They need to get in here quick, though. That bomb is ticking down. They have three kits, so they have the extra time to work with. But it's just trade frags all over the place, and they might actually do this. Optic, the Molotov seals the deal. Just no time to get the defuse in, and they will be able to finally break the streak.
Just a little bit going their way. That's going to be the first round they win on the terrorist side of this map. So I'm not sure it feels great, because they probably still know that they're quite far behind. But yeah, good round there, and a good pacing as well. I like it. Just continuously going. I mean, Daps, it was a big risk for him to try and plant that early on, because they didn't have too much coverage. Mm-hmm. But you saw how much pressure that puts on NIP later on. So you got to give him some credit as well for not hesitating too much there. Great smokes coming out of Optic. Just lining up on both sides. Well, actually just the one side of Electric there, but that might create some space for Rush to get out behind.
Yeah, I like it a lot, actually. Gives him some room to maneuver with. Forrest did get that smoke down on Pop Dog, but now with the information here, maybe that allows for the Pop Dog man to actually push out. That's Rush holding that angle. Smokes are clearing up, though. Optic still have three players over at an alley. They're trying to make use of that AWP with Mixwell, so we'll see if he can find that first pick. Somebody might go for the peek. Exist is currently shoulder peeking it. He's going to step out into the open, and Mixwell, easy shot for him. So there's the man advantage now for Optic.
Pyth trying for the refrag, but not connecting with anyone yet. They still have three men in the safe bomb site, so they can put up a pretty good defense right now. The bomb is down at Ivy, so it looks like they're going to commit to this A bomb site. Get Right actually falling back, trying to see if he can rotate in quickly as well. Pyth going down, Forrest next in line, and great start for Optic here. Freiberg gets two before he falls, and now it's all on Get Right here. One versus three, which is a place that he's normally very good at.
What? Miscommunication from Mixwell? How does he not realize that Get Right's behind him like that? Interesting choice. That actually puts it within the realm of possibility here for Get Right. Flash is around the corner. He has so many angles to check. But if he finds one more kill, this could change everything. And Naf, not exactly in the best spot to deal with this either. On the other side of that smoke, Incendiary goes down. If Get Right were to try and stick this, he might actually be able to get that defuse. There's the roast and toast on Daps. And now it's going to be Nafly, the last man alive here for Optic, coming around the corner and taking out Get Right. So a good clutch win there for Nafly. That should give Optic some confidence.
Bit scary for a moment, and I agree, it looked like Mixwell had either wasn't really paying attention or someone called the wrong thing for him. It's hard to know which one at this point, but 15-7. And what's necessary for Optic is eight more rounds in a row to bring it into overtime, even.
Exactly, so it seems like they've got a little bit of wind under their wings, right? They're starting to get they're starting to actually do something here, Optic, and they have a chance to just continue to extend Well, not extend, really. What, catch up? NIP are on eco. They have pistols, so Optic have a good chance in this round to just, you know, at least shut them down and give themselves a little bit more confidence here.
Yeah, there is something to work with right now if you're on the Optic side, and if nothing else, they're at least also getting a chance to really test out their T side here. You know, they're getting some rounds in, and they're getting a chance to see what works and what doesn't. It's very hard to come back from this much of a deficit. Getting some good kills in here against just the pistols, and Forrest trapped in the back there somewhere, trying to see if he can make it out, but that won't be allowed either. Stan and Rush picking up a double kill each and making it to 8-15. The money back for NIP. Wouldn't be surprised if we're going to see some aggression out of them in a round like this, just to try and sort of kill this game and just move on.
Yeah, sure. They can go. They haven't. They've gone aggressive B halls. They've gone aggressive alley. They haven't really gone towards Pop Dog or main yet, Nip. So I'm wondering if that's how they're going to try and change things up. I mean, Pyth has the AWP again, though, so he could try and go for that alley peek again, but he isn't. Instead, he's changing it up, looking towards A main, and it is going to be, once again, Daps, Mixwell, everybody just charging out here for Optic.
Yeah, four men still here for NIP, and a little bit of a smoke coming up, and it's just too late. Daps, and then Stan and Nafly also picking up a kill each. Get Right very nearly being shot through the smoke, and he pushes through and actually gets the kill on Rush. That's got to be so annoying. He would have died if he'd got one more bullet on him. And instead of actually just fleeing and running away with 6 HP, he goes and gets a kill.
And they're both changing up their positioning right now. NIP, they're on point, working together as a unit. Get Right is low on HP. He's only got the 6, but Exist has now changed it up. They've shown each other on opposite sides of the map, so now they're going to try and meet in the middle here at Connector. And so Exist, he's the one with the HP. There is a kit on Get Right picked up as well. But Exist is currently hoping for somebody to make a mistake on Optic's side. Get Right's now got a line onto that bomb site. He's going to spot them. And there's the info. Now, does Exist win this duel? Yes, he does. Bomb gets dropped on the wrong side of the box, though. Exist could have got a lucky break if that bomb dropped on his side. He could have just sat there and held the angle. But now Daps has to figure out how to win this in a 1v1.
What was Stan doing in that case? I just don't know. That looked like an insane play from his point of view. Exist going to be right on the other side here. He does hear the bomb going down, and it's not a fake. That's cool in that round. Exist going to be walking out. Look at the wrong way, and Daps just finding the perfect timing, getting a kill for himself and making it a double, in fact. So we move into the 25th round, and NIP still not quite with the money yet.
They're in a similar situation to the one that Optic was in the first half, where they're getting reset. Their money, they aren't able to keep it together. They're constantly at this point getting dropped down to 3,000 starting money. That's not quite enough to go for a full buy. So, well, not quite. It's pretty far off the mark. They're about $2,000 short. So again, they're gonna go for a half buy with some pistols, get a couple of nades in there, and see what they can do. Scary thing is that, you know, last time they were on pistols, NIP, they came pretty close. And, well, Freiburg had a chance there to find an opening shot, but he gets caught in a crossfire. Not going to happen. Nafly with the aggression straight towards Alley will catch out Exist. And it's going to be Get Right and Forrest last two alive here for NIP, but not for long. Although, as I say that, Forrest does find a nice shot. Just a little bit of a parting shot. Two kills there for NIP.
Three members of Optic surviving, but, I mean, money is not their major concern right now. It's not like they're going to be saving for any upcoming round. If they lose, they're out of the map. And NIP this time, because they've lost a couple of rounds in a row and they saved, they're going to be in a really good position. They have everything they could want right now. We'll see if they can put it to good use. 26th round coming up. And Optic, I mean, I think they're playing pretty well right now. And they're also, you can tell, all the fear has gone away. And here's my big worry. And I'm almost willing to bet you this. If this goes to 15-14, that's exactly when Optic are going to slip up. Because then they will start to think too much about the game again. They'll think, oh, we're almost doing this. And then everything will slow down. Everyone will start to hesitate again. And they are almost doing it this round here. Just more speed and a little bit more aggression.
Yeah, oh, there's a shot, and Pyth not going to hit it, but Forrest is looking for the flank. He's going to catch them out. Big spray from him. Not quite winning. Yes, he does get the second, but he runs out of bullets. Pyth is there to get the shot onto Stanislaw, though, so Nip maintained that man advantage, and somehow Get Right finds a long-range shot onto Mixwell. Pyth drops Daps, and it's down to Rush. 1v2. Bomb dropped out in the open as well on the other side of the main train. So he's looking for Freiburg, he's looking for Pyth, then he loses the duel versus Freiburg. It's over. 16-10, NIP shutting Optic out of the second map. Despite Optic, actually, you know, there was a bit of balance there in the second half. 5 rounds in a row for NIP, then Optic come back 5 rounds in a row. But the streak was not meant to last forever. NIP, they eventually got the job done and go up 2-0 in the groups.
Yeah, I'd be very curious if Optic have the same sort of feeling that it's only the end of the halves or end of the games that everyone wakes up. It seems like they're just being way too slow in the beginning, and they need to start off with the pace that they sort of end these games with. A bit of a shame, because that was an interesting second half. When we come back, we're going to have a breakdown off this second map here on Train, but NIP end up taking both maps against Optic, both Cobblestone and Train, as maybe was predicted. We'll throw it to the analyst after a break.